The number of census workers alleging Statistics New Zealand and its recruiter have breached employment law has doubled. The group is now seeking more than $200,000 in lost income in a case that goes to mediation next month. Business correspondent Corazon Miller with this exclusive report.
Lovely to see you.
A friendship formed over mutual frustration that an offer of 6 weeks' work on the census turned out to be anything but.
It was really frustrating and a bit stressful because I was in the process of looking for to buy a house, and I was thinking that money was going to be used for, you know, the house.
Frustration merged to a degree of anger. How can a government department treat people like this?
The number of census workers alleging Statistics New Zealand and its recruiter have breached employment law has grown. They've joined a group which One News first reported on in March. Workers described feeling misled over hours and pay, which were at times less than expected. The group's now grown to 19 and has lodged a personal grievance seeking $249,000 in compensation.
Well, obviously it's daunting. We don't have a legal background, none of the group. A lot of them are beneficiaries. We don't have this sort of experience, and I think it's really unfair.
Both Statistics New Zealand and recruitment agency PSK say they can't comment while the legal process is underway. We also approached the Minister responsible for Statistics New Zealand, Deborah Russell. In a statement, she said it would be premature and inappropriate to comment and that it remains an operational matter. The opposition says that's not good enough.
These staff deserve protection under the law. They need the Minister to be backing them. This process has been chaotic from the start.
It appears to be that Stats New Zealand is trying to pass on blame here, and really they should just be stepping in rather than lawyering up at the cost of the taxpayer.
The parties are going to a voluntary mediation overseen by the Ministry of Business next month.
No worker in New Zealand should be treated like this.
Well, I just hope that from this, it doesn't happen again.
These workers saying they just want accountability for what went wrong. Corazon Miller, One News.